Hi, my name is Jessica Deen, and I'm a cloud developer advocate with Microsoft. Today, we're going to talk about building a Docker image and pushing it to Azure Container Registry, all using Visual Studio Team services. So let's get started. I'm already logged into my VSTS account, so I'm going to automatically go and create a new project. Now, the first thing I'm going to have to do is give it a project name. So I'm going to go ahead and call it .NET Containers, because I actually want to build a Docker image with a .NET Core application. Now, once the project creates, the first thing it's going to ask is, where do you have your code? I can push from an existing repository on the command line. I can import a repository. I can even build code from an external repository. For today's demo, I'm actually going to import a repository because I already have my code living out in GitHub. I'm going to enter in the Git URL, and I'm going to hit import. Now, as soon as my code is imported, I'm actually going to be taken over to where I can see the code in my Visual Studio Team Services repo. And the reason I chose to import my code is VSTS actually gives me free, unlimited private repos. So for the purpose of the project today, I'm already going to have my code already local in VSTS. So I'm going to click here to navigate and view my code. And I can see that it looks like it was successfully imported. So I can click down into source. I can see that I have my test folder and I have my .NET source code. Perfect. So if I go back to the Git repo root, right up above in the top right-hand corner, under fork and clone, I see that VSTS is already walking me through the next part of my process, which is going to be to set up my build. So I'm going to simply click that button, and in a new tab, it's going to open up my continuous integration or my CI setup. Now, since I am going to build a Docker image in container, but I'm using a .NET Core application, I'm actually going to choose to start with a .NET Core template that VSTS provides. If I didn't want to use a template, I can even start with an empty process. But we're going to do a template today because it's easier. So I'm going to hit apply, and it's going to add in tasks that make sense for a .NET Core application. Now, the first thing we see under process, underneath the name is actually something that says agent queue. So if you're new to VSTS, let me talk a bit about agents real quick. Agents are computers that VSTS gives you completely for free to run your builds and your releases on. So you can do anything from hosted Visual Studio 2017 to hosted Windows, hosted Linux Preview, and even hosted Mac OS. So it's really neat. We give you computers for any language, any platform. Now, there's certain instances where you might want to use your own computer for build or release. To do that, it's really simple. You would simply click on the gear up here in the very top, so we can take a look at that. And then when you hover over it, you actually see agent queues right underneath. Now, when you click it, and I already have it open in another tab for you, when you click that, you immediately are taken to your page where you can set up additional private agents. You can see that you can download an agent and set it up on Windows, OS X, or Linux. Now, the reason why you might want your own private agent, we're going to talk about a little bit later on in this video. For now, let's go back to our build. Now, I'm going to leave hosted VS 2017 as the agent I'm going to use for this .NET Core application. Now, I'm going to go through and take a look at what's happening on the phases or the task runner, which is over here on the left-hand side. So I see that it already added in tasks for .NET Restore, .NET Build, Test, and Publish. But this Publish artifact task would publish files that I would need for my release. Since I'm building an image and I'm pushing it to Azure Container Registry, I actually don't need this task. So I'm going to go ahead and remove it. However, I do need additional tasks that are going to make sense for this project. So I'm going to go ahead and add those now. I simply search in the field and hit Add. There's a few more that I need, so I'm going to go ahead and add those in. And then I also need a Docker task. I actually need two Docker tasks, right? Because I need a task for build, and then I need a task for push. So we'll go ahead and add that in twice. Great. So I can see the new tasks that I added over on the left-hand side. And since this is a task runner, all I have to do is move these around in the order that makes sense. Great. So now I'm going to go through and fill out the values that I need for each one of those tasks. So for npm install, I'm actually going to change this to version 0 because I want to use arguments. and I'm going to tell it that I want it to install Bower. So we're going to do Bower, and then I'm also going to say allow root because I want it to have root access. Now the next thing I have to do is from command line, again, these are tasks that are being run on those computers that VSTS is giving for you. The next thing I have to do is I have to tell it that I want it to run that tool I just had it install. So I'm going to go ahead and click over here in Tool, and I'm going to enter Bower. Now, again, I also still want to make sure that I don't have any issues with permissions, so I'm going to allow root. The next thing I have to do is point the working folder for that task, for where I want it to run Bower, and I'm going to point it to where I have my Bower JSON. And I see that I do have my Bower JSON right in this folder, so I'll just hit OK. So now I see that that is the proper folder. Now, the neat thing is, because we chose a template, I actually don't need to make any changes to my restore, my build, my test, or even my publish tasks. Everything is already pre-entered and pre-configured for what makes sense for this project. The next thing I have to do is just set up my build and push tests for my Docker container image that I'm going to push out into Azure. So the first thing I'm going to do, I can give it a build name, I'm going to leave it as is. I see under Container Registry that it already has Azure Container Registry selected for me. Now, if I wanted to use a third-party registry, I could drop down and simply choose Container Registry. I am going to leave it as ACR for today. Now, I'm going to choose an Azure subscription. Where does my ACR, or my Azure Container Registry, live? In this case, it lives in my Microsoft internal subscription. As soon as I select it, another box pops up, which prompts me to authorize. Once I hit that, VSTS is actually going to go out and set up the authentication to my Azure subscription so it can automatically give me access into that container registry. I don't have to set up any username, password, credentials. It simplifies the process. Great. So now that that finished authorizing, I can click the drop-down arrow under Azure Container Registry, and I see my registry is already available. So I'll click that. Still, VSTS is still walking me through. What's the next thing I want to do? I want to build an image. Great, I'm going to leave that action as is. Now, do I want to specify a direct link to my Docker file? I do. So if I hit the ellipses on the right-hand side, again, I can choose the location of my Docker file from my Git repo. So I'll hit source, we'll drop down into my .NET, scroll down a little bit, and there's my Docker file. So I'll select that, hit OK, and my Docker file is now selected. I don't have any build arguments, and I am going to use the default build context. I'm going to leave the image name as build repository name with build ID. These are built-in parameters by VSTS, again, for you to use, and it will automatically populate the information accordingly. Now, the last thing I like to do is also check this box for including the latest tag. This way, when VSTS builds my image, it's not only going to tag it with the build ID, but it's also going to update the latest tag to use that image as well. Now, the second task, I'm just going to go through and repeat all the things that I did for the first task. The only thing I don't have to repeat is setting up the Azure subscription, because it's already authorized as a service connection for this project. So I can just go through and quickly select my registry again. And this time, I'm going to change the action to push, because we're pushing that image that we just built in the previous step. Now I'm going to scroll down a little bit more, and the last thing I want to check is, again, latest tag. Because, again, not only did it build and tag it, I now want to push both the build ID and the tag. So now there's nothing else for me to check. All I have to do is hit save and queue. There's going to be one final window where I can enter in save comments or commit information. I don't need to enter in anything else for this project, and I'll just hit save and queue. VSTS is now going to automatically queue off a build, and we can go take a look and see what's happening. Great, so I can see that the build has started. It's initializing the hosted agent that, again, is provided for us. And it has now started the job. So we can actually watch as this job goes through and completes. It's going to run through a list of tasks that it has set up. And one thing I wanted to mention, we'll circle back to something that I mentioned earlier in the video. I mentioned how it might make more sense in certain situations to have a private agent. The reason why is because the hosted agent is just a computer you use one time. So when you're building Docker images specifically, and container images, your Docker file is going to pull what we call layers. Now, when you use a private agent or you do a build on your own system, it's going to end up caching those layers so that the next time you build, it doesn't have to re-pull. Therefore, it speeds up future builds. However, when this process is running on a hosted agent, each time you kick it off, it's going to re-pull down the layers. So that's going to mean that the build is going to take potentially 5 to 6 minutes the first time. Each time you would repeat that build with a hosted agent, it would take the same amount of time. If you did have your own private agent, it could take 30 seconds to a minute because it's not going to have to take all that time caching layers, rebuilding, repulling, etc. So we're going to go ahead and let this job run. Like I said, it will take about 5 to 6 minutes, and I'll come check in with you when this is finished. Great, so now my job finished, and you can see it did take almost 7 minutes for it to complete. If I were using a private agent, the next time around I run it, the time would be a lot shorter, but that's it. In less than 7 minutes, and then maybe 5 minutes to set up your build task, in under 15 minutes, you can get started with building and pushing a Docker image into Azure Container Registry using VSTS. Now, if you want to know what to do with that image after you've built it and pushed it, you're going to want to check out some of my other videos where I walk you through how to set up from scratch a project using, again, still VSTS, but taking that Docker image and ultimately pushing it out into a Kubernetes cluster. Thanks for watching and have a great day.